Have you ever noticed how some people continually play the victim in life? It doesn't matter where or in what circumstances, how bad things got, it's always someone else's fault that they are in the circumstance that they, willingly, of their own volition, put themselves into. Those folks will never have an ounce of peace in life. Why? Because they won't own their problems. That leads me to today's lectionary gospel lesson, Matthew chapter 3, verses 1 through 6. Story of how John the Baptist comes on the scene. He's baptizing people for repentance. John's a bit of a moralist. He comes out of the wilderness and he's telling everybody what they should and what they shouldn't do. But there's one thing he did get right. He tells them that the Spirit will empower their hearts to follow God. The softening of the heart that occurs when the Spirit intervenes is where our lives can be changed and peace can be added to our souls. Matthew quotes the prophet Isaiah there from chapter 40, verse 3, where he says, "Prepare the way of the Lord. Make his paths straight. Clear a highway in the wilderness or the desert." That imagery there is really powerful, because in the Greek, it's in the imperative mood. It's a commandment. It's as if a military officer is overlooking a battlefield and then tells his troops, "Attack now." There's no debating it. There's no talking about it. They go and they follow. The other imagery there is that the coronation of a king. It's a motorcade. God is here. God's going here in our lives. And there's a space in between. It's a parade. Tell the servants to go before, clean the road up, so that the king has a clear ride where he is going. What does that mean for us? I think there are things in our lives that we need to prepare the way for by cleaning up the highway. Where God is and where God wants to go in our lives, there's space. There's junk in the road. Isaiah said to clear that path. What is that? Those things are probably some behaviors that we have that we know we need to change. Maybe it's the fact that we need to forgive someone when we've been holding on to unforgiveness in our hearts. So no matter what the rocks are, what the junk in the road might be, God invites us to clean it out of the way and prepare our souls. And with that, remember that you are loved. Be blessed.